Nearly 100 bus routes for public schools are still impacted by the driver shortage. From lower license requirements to downsizing vehicles for school transportation, a few lawmakers are trying to tackle the root of the problem. Christy Tomashiro reports.
Pearl City High School was just one of 14 schools whose bus service was cut due to a driver shortage last year. Parents say the issue is ongoing and forcing some to even change work schedules to pick up their kids.
It's kind of hard because he said he got a walk far to take the bus. Yeah, and not every day I can pick him up.
For Pearl City High School students, they now have to walk down the hill from school to get to the nearest city bus stop to go home. Some state lawmakers are trying to address the school bus driver shortage with a couple bills moving through the legislature.
The Department of Education says 99 school bus routes remain impacted, leaving over 16,000 students utilizing the city bus. Governor Josh Green issued an emergency proclamation in August, allowing exemptions for vehicles other than school buses to be used for school transportation. A bill is now proposing to make that a permanent solution.
This would be motor coaches, minivans, and small buses. And what we're doing with this bill is making these exemptions permanent.
Because of the Maui situation, we have had to resort to that, and it's worked well. The small tour bus companies had excess capacities.
But the DOE says the root of the issue is a shortage of drivers with a commercial driver's license. The DOE adds there are currently 507 school bus drivers, a decline from pre-pandemic times. Another bill aims to mandate school bus contractors to use smaller vehicles like passenger vans that don't require a CDL.
We are able to get students to and from their campuses safely by utilizing a workforce that doesn't have to be retrained.
Depending on the route and the number of students per route, we could probably do some analysis on that.
Both bills have passed out of their respective committees. The DOE adds it will also explore a new school bus service contract in July. Christy Tomashiro, K212 News, working for Hawaii.